Okay, now maybe you have fear, you have shy to raise your hand. I never seen anyone quitting smoking by Mukesh acts. Okay, unnecessary one temperature. Unnecessarily people killed him. Okay, but unfortunate thing is that no one changed because of Mukesh death. People keep smoking. In fact, they will smoke a SRB. See, they will speak something called Vedanta, philosophy. In here you will die. And everyone is going for bar and drinking every day. The sales are growing. After 2008, what happened? Decision has it. And they have seen, what about the sales of Kingfisher? The registered company is not Breweries, Vijay Mallya's company. They were able to find a surprising facts. The sales have doubled or tripled. Because earlier, if you take liquor of 1 or 2 pegs, you are drinking at a restaurant or bar, which is costing 300 rupees per peg. Now, after that, people lost the jobs. When people lost the job, they are not affordable to go to bar. They are buying a full bottle and drinking at home only. Okay, so here, some surprising thing is that tomorrow I need to go to office. I already lost my job. So, poor Peter Soja. This is a good thing happened. Whether you buy in the restaurant or whether you buy in the wine shop, money will go to Vijay Mallya only, right? Okay, that is a good thing happened. Consumption patterns, spending patterns will remain stable and decreasing only. Depend on the fashions and tastes of the consumers. Okay, so again, population growth, I never see a single year where there is a fall in the population of India. Okay, I hope I will not see in the next 100 years also. So, population increases, spending patterns increases. Prices of raw materials also, major key factor. Because you are in the living in a very competitive environment of FMCG. Okay, highly competitive. Today you will come out with a 1 rupee shampoo. Tomorrow another company will come out with a 50 paisa shampoo. 25 paisa shampoo. And 25 paisa kya shampoo milega? They are giving, no. You take it. So you are living in a highly competitive world here. That is a major concern for these companies, only the competition. Okay, only the competition that matters. Of course, they will be able to ride out the competition. That's not difficult because of the brand building. Now, as I said, these companies will have the constant growth irrespective of economic situation. Okay, so let us see the graphs of these stocks. We have few listed companies, HUL, ITC, Dabur, Marico, and Godrej Consumer, and Procter & Gamble. Yes, India GDP 2008 has gone up. You can see here, 2008-2009, before recession it has gone up. And see what happened to ITC stock. It has also gone up. Now, continue. What happened to GDP of India? Again, continue till 2011. The recovery fall has happened 7-8. Recovery started slowly. But again, if you see, ITC is continuing doing well. Next. Economic recovery crashed because of higher inflation, especially, or you can say fortunately, to change the fate of India, the GDP touched a 10-year low of 4.5% in the past 1 year. That is really good sign, because people will start hating the existing government, we will go for a good government. Okay, so the GDP crashed, will it change your consumption patterns? No, ITC continues to go up. It's a good problem. Either the economic recovery or fall, ITC will continue to do very well. Move on. So the continuation happens till 2012-13 as well, and the stock price continues to do very well. Next. See the stock price of ITC, 2009, when the economic fall has continued, 2094, and today the price is 347. In other words, money has just more than tripled in 4 years' time. A return of 350%, it's a whooping return of 350%. In fact, I don't know how many of you are aware, this is the only company has done extremely well. This is the topmost performance of Sensex companies in the past 5 years. As usual, Dabur, as usual, Sensex. You see, Sensex is more or less stable. Okay, there is not much return generated by Sensex, but Dabur has gone up from 49 rupees to 173 today. You can see the graphs here, ITC in the blue line and Dabur is in the orange line. They have completely outperformed the Sensex. If you draw the graph for only banking stocks are the proxy for Indian economy, which will do exactly on par with Sensex. The second sector where one can invest is cement. Cement industry is also a company, ACC, Gujarat Ambuja, Ultratech, India Cements. Yeah, Bharti Cement, but that is not listed company, that is unlisted. In equity markets, we are concerned about listed companies only. Unlisted companies, you cannot get into the company, right? They won't allow you. Fine. Economic condition. When infrastructure growth is very well, government is spending for roads, buildings, projects. Okay, cement consumption will increase. Obviously, sales will increase, profit will increase. And real estate, people are buying properties left and right. There was no city called Hi-Tech City 20 years back. There was no place called Vishwanagar 20 years back. People are keep on constructing houses. The demand for housing has gone up. And seasonality. What is the seasonality, sir? Timing of monsoon. There will be no cement demand in the month of August, September because of heavy rainfall. No one will go for construction. So, those periods the cement sales will be quite low. Stock prices are also bound to fall. Okay, when it comes to May, June, July, there will be huge bump up in the activity of construction and prices are bound to go up for cement also, which will lead to increase in the sales of the companies, which will lead to increase in the stock price. Remember, stock price is function of top line and bottom line. Okay, now have a look at a few companies. So here the excise duty. Excise duty is reduced by government. Obviously, the demand will increase because of lower cement prices. If excise duty increased, the demand will come down. Now, there are a few companies, there are more than 20 companies in the stock markets about cement, and there are a few companies, ACC, Ambuja, Grasim, Ultratic, and India Cements, owned by Srinivasan. Now, move on. What is the relationship between GDP and cement stocks? Yes, this is also a sector which is a proxy for Indian economy. Have a look at here. The stock price in the year 2003 was 80 rupees. Yes, economic boom was not started. India is about to see the biggest or longest economic boom in 2003. Okay, stock price was 80 rupees and has gone up to a return of 1300 rupees. You can see the price. It has gone up drastically from 2004. Yes, you have to buy the stock at 80. If you buy the stock at 1300, thinking that economic recovery will continue, no, it won't happen. Okay, that will be the experience. There are two types of people in the market who will invest in the market and lose the investment, get experience. Second people are there in investment markets who will invest in the market, lose the money and even without get experience also. Keep burning their fingers. Okay, they are the 95% of the people. But experience will make you to ensure that you will not have an investment for an investment now. Okay, be careful. So the prices has gone up, skyrocketed to 1300. After the economic boom hit Indian stock markets, the price crashed. Because you might be knowing real estate prices crashed because no demand for buying houses. Infrastructure crashed, no cement roads because government still is running fiscal deficit. So this procedure continued and the fall continued, the price has come down to 500 rupees. But fortunately in the past 1 year, where we are about to see economic boom, prices has slowly gone up to 1500, but again fall has happened. Okay, it is also subject to economic cycles. Every stock in the market in 2009-2010 have crashed drastically because the global recession hit every company in the market. Move on. Another sector which is very much famous, you are the drivers of the economic sector. I should put your names also. Okay, I can keep conducting classes and students will use their mobile phones. Keep messaging your boyfriends, girlfriends. Okay, you will have 2-3 SIM cards. Because 2-3 girlfriends you have, you don't want to give one number to another girlfriend. Correct? So, here, telecom sector, remember 2001 still I remember, where people did not have mobile phones. When you see mobile phones, you show to everyone, hey, this is those days, there was one, you know what we call, 3300 Nokia. 3300 If you want to hit someone, hit me, that phone, he will die. Okay. It is a big case study, how come that phone is so strong? I still remember, one of my friends, when I was doing my CA in Chennai, his mobile phone slipped out of pocket and one bus has run out of the price for this mobile phone. Only screen damage. Rest of the phone is working very well. Okay, that's a big surprise. It is a case study, how come they are able to manufacture the strongest phones? Okay, you just hit with someone, he will definitely get hurt. Okay, now, those are the days where you show some mobile phone, I got a mobile, you will show to everyone. Today, if I show that you are using 003-15 to anyone, they will slap you. Stupid, where are you? You should buy Samsung, Galaxy Tab, Tab 2, Tab 3, Tab 4, iPhone, 4 years, 5, 5 years, 6 years, 7 years. Okay, people are getting crazy. Those days where the revenue per user happens to be, you remember, I don't know, one of you know, those days incoming was chargeable. Huh? So people were not getting the, picking up the phone also. You have to give missed call, they will call from their office. Because office will go to bosses now. Okay, this is what is happening. But after that, what happened? The number of subscribers increased. The revenues of companies increased. First, they captured a city's market. Okay, that is urban market. Saturated. Everyone, once you get mobile phone, there is nothing left for you, right? I can sell only one mobile phone to you, one SIM card. After that, I am not bothered. Anyway, you will use it. Okay, anyway, you will continue to use the mobile phone. And I could see some people who once they have got engaged, this mobile company celebrate. Wow, lot of people got engaged. Because they will come out with offers, one-to-one mobile phone free, whole night free. But daytime you will be calling, no. So that will be chargeable. You cannot say, darling, whole night free, tomorrow morning I will not call you. She will come and slap you. So you have to call her even in the daytime also. So companies used to celebrate this kind of bumper offers. The number of subscriber base increased. Urban market captured. Then, rural market, people who do not know mobile phones also, they were coming with local language. They were telling, this is how to use mobile phone. I did not find a single person without mobile phone so far, especially nowadays. Okay, no one is having a mobile phone. Everyone is having mobile. Now, market saturated. One country cross population, 100 crore mobile phones are there. Some people are having 3-4 SIM cards also. Okay. So, there is no one who is left with mobile phone, market saturation has happened. Now, even the kids are there, 4 years, 5 years, they cannot use mobile phone, they are left from the market. They are not the customers, they will be the potential customers. Now, who are not using, sir? People who are in the coma and hospital, where they cannot use any mobile phone. Old age people who do not know how to use mobile phone. And people who are in jail. Okay, these are the people who are not allowed to use mobile phone, sir. And so if you already have mobile phones, market saturated. Now the problem starts. Yes, TRAI regulations also another factor which impacts stock prices. You remember TRAI is there, which has come out with saying that there was nothing called SMS offers and all. They were offering SMS for 1 rupee per SMS. TRAI has come out and said, show me the reason why you are charging 1 rupee per SMS. Companies had to give offers. There is nothing called price rigging and all. They have to fight them. Okay. Those period has gone where you can manipulate the prices of the selling price to the customer by bid rigging and all. That won't happen. So the competition continued. Now, what happened to stock prices? What are listed companies here? Bharti Airtel, Idea, Tata Communications. These companies were doing extremely well till 2008-2009. Sir, is it because of recession the prices have fallen? No. Did you ever stop calling your girlfriend because of recession? She will come and slap you, correct? Okay, so this is the main communication. Going back to see the cyclicality of telecom industry. See, this guy is talking with 4 persons at a time. Okay, you might have seen Lalu Prasad Yadav. When this journalist comes with mobile, he will take all the mobiles and he will be talking, correct? So, here what happens? 2002-2003, when the telecom boom is not there, no one noticed someone will be there, people will be using telecom. They won't note and notice that market are in 4 rupees. That was the biggest luxury those days. So, no penetration. So, like penetration increased, obviously sales increased, profits increased, stock price increased. Stock price is a function of top line and bottom line. Top line refers to sales and bottom line refers to profits. Prices gone up, from 40 rupees to 570 rupees in the matter of 5 years. Sir, any stock is like this now, where I can buy, it will become 50 to 570. Yes, I can give you the stock. Whether it will go to 570 or not, I will tell you after 5 years. Not now. Okay, don't ask me. Fine. Moving ahead, if you observe previous slide shows that FDI has hit the sector. Those days, no foreign investment. Now, foreign companies are allowed to invest in the FDI. For example, you have seen Tata Docomo. That is a joint venture. Docomo is a Japanese company tied up with Indian company. And Uninor. That is a Unitech Indian company and Telenor is a Switzerland company. Both joined together. And Vodafone. Vodafone is a company from UK. So, Here, these companies have come and hit the market with the price wars. And the prices crashed. Unfortunately, the sales crashed, revenues crashed, profits crashed, and the prices crashed to 270 rupees. Sir, will the recovery happen? Yes. Some people have withdrawn from the market. Telenor is already in the losses. Anytime they withdraw from Indian markets, after that there will be some 2-3 companies having monopoly, then the prices will go up. Okay, then the sales will go up, profits will go up. Another reason is that now data usage increased. People are not only using mobile phone for calling, they are using for downloading songs, movies, or internet. The data usage may be the trigger for next movement telecom stocks. But to what extent? Fortunately, in the last 1 year, this Airtel stock has, Airtel company has reported increase in the sales. Okay, that is a good sign that stock prices may be going up telecom sector, but not sure. Only sector where we are bullish on now is only banking. Move on. Now, IT, you might be knowing very well, these IT stocks, you might be seeing lot of people going to USA, working in Infosys, TCS. You will think, when we will get our day? Correct? You will be writing CA panel fourth attempt, you will go to marriage. First question they ask, hey, I am going for USA, I have got visa, day after tomorrow I am leaving to USA. What about your CA? I am writing my first group fourth attempt. Okay, now I got an exemption also. After CA, I am going to hypothesis. Within very 1 year, near future, we will complete our CA. Now result is quite happy, I am quite happy with my results now, they are giving 3%. So tomorrow, day after, I will pass my CA. Now these are things which irritate us, we should not go for any marriages. Because marriages is not for CA students, this is not for marriages, no? we should avoid these marriages. No? Okay. We should avoid going for marriages, not getting married. Okay, don't take it the other way. You can get married after your CA, because once you are qualified, no, it will take some 6 months for you to realize that you are also a normal human being. Okay, till that time you will think I am a scientist, I am a person who lost everything, I am bankrupt. Okay, when you go to marriage, you will find people, everyone is happy. All people are happy. Why? I have taken CA 6 years back, still in CA final. Na karma endika la gali poyindi. Ila nadiya naage enduku vachindi. Correct? You will think, why karma has gone in the wrong direction? Everyone else is happy, no? They are not doing CA, but they are happy, right? They are very much happy than us, sir. They are very, very much happy than us, sir. Even after you pass CA, you are not sure of getting a salary of 15-20,000. Okay, the salary offered nowadays is 10-12,000, which is less than what the GHMC people are getting. Okay, we tested the new laws, it is better to go for GHMC, yeah? Fine, let us move on. So we will think, 4,000 plus bus pass, that is the salary offered based on CFO, for qualified CA. Yeah? Fine, now, coming back here, IT sector. If US economy is doing very well, every country will go to USA. I don't know what they will do. Working game, money bottle. Whether these people, what they are doing, is it that American people cannot do? We don't know all these facts. We are concerned only one thing. When US economy is doing well, there will be more products coming into India. More IT companies will get revenues. When more IT companies get revenues, stock prices will go up because of more sales. That is the one factor. Second factor. Second biggest customer for exports of IT is European economies. So you keep exporting to Europe economy, that will also add a lot of revenue for IT companies located. Now, another important reason why IT companies are flourishing, in the past 6 months, the price of Infosys has gone up by 50%. From 2000 rupees to 3500, it is more than 50% return. The reason is simple. There is no change in the company fundamentals. Only change is that the company revenues has increased. You remember AS 11, accounting for FX transactions, which says that you are getting $1 lakh, earlier you are recognizing at 15 lakh rupees. Now the dollar price is 69, in the 3 months back it went to 69, where you are able to report at 69 rupees profit. Your profit has spiked like anything. Okay, that is the biggest driver for the company's stock prices. Government policies. Indian government is allowing SEZs and tax benefit for the companies incorporated in SEZs. So that is another reason why IT companies are getting more benefit from the government That is a major driver for the employment for the government. Tax benefit in USA.
What, sir?
Tax benefit in USA. Lot of US companies are outsourcing the job for India, not because Indians are doing extremely well. Whatever the job you do, they can also do very happily. There, if they recruit someone, they have to pay $8,000 per month. If they recruit the same person in Hyderabad, they have to pay $30,000 per month. Remember, $8,000 per month into 56 rupees, that is the cost per American guy. Now, if they recruit the same guy in Hyderabad, anyone can do the job. Okay, don't think that your cousins are doing something great in the city between four walls. If you can train, you can also do the job. Okay, one day training is sufficient. Right. Coming back here, so the sales of the company getting impacted by tax benefit. Now, when they are outsourcing the job for Indian companies, the local people in US are losing the jobs. When local people in US are losing the jobs, government said, "Array, companies like IBM, Microsoft, or Oracle Corporation, don't give jobs for India, give employment in US only. If you don't agree for that, I will not give tax benefit for you. If you are recruiting more people in US itself, I will give more tax benefit." So some companies lured by this tax benefit in USA, they decided to not to outsource for Indian companies. That will impact Obama, before he was coming for elections in 2008, he said publicly that I will stop outsourcing for India. Okay, now there was a common joke in USA. If someone is lost a job, Bangalore is IT hub for India, where jobs are lost in USA and created in Bangalore. So it is said that if someone lost job in USA, "Arey, what happened to your job?" He said, "My job is Bangalore. Bangalore means I lost my job to Bangalore. My job is Bangalore." Okay, so that is a common joke. Now, what is the competition from Asian countries? You will find this Tapu Mahalo, all these Asians who does not know proper English also, Philippines, Thailand, Taiwan, Indonesia, they are much more poor than India. If you are working for 30,000 salary, they will work 30 times food in a day. That is sufficient. So they are also learning English to give competition for India. An unfortunate part is that our people are only going to teach English there. You are killing economy, man. I am concerned about how much I am making money. I know English, I can't anything else. So I will go to China, I will teach English there. What will happen to Indian people? Let them lose their job. Okay, so there was another joke then started in India. It is a turn of Bangaloreans to be Bangalore. That means Bangalore is losing jobs for Asian economies. Okay, so that is another competition for IT sector. But other than that is another sector which has nothing to do with Indian economy. In other words, if India crashes now, they will be happy because dollar price will go to 69, 70, 75. They are the only people who celebrate the dollar crash or rupee crash. The dollar price goes to 80, everyone will be crying because they have to pay more amount for petrol. IT companies will be enjoying. Yes, we made more profits. Move on. What are the companies listed here? TCS, Infy, Wipro, HCL, Tech, list goes on. We have seen some five companies, list is unlimited. Move on. Now, this is a company which has strongly correlated to US economy. As I said, if US is doing well, they will get more projects. If US is doing bad, they are gone. See, 2006-07, US economy has done extremely well. The prices has gone up for Infosys top also. From 1000 rupees to 2600 rupees. Come down. Next, 2008, US went into crisis. Infosys top also went into crisis. And later the recovery started in USA and Infosys stock price also zoomed back. Okay, this is where you have to understand whether the US will do very well or not before buying stock of Infosys. Okay, move on. Continue. You may be knowing very well, I still remember real estate means, it was in 2006, one of my friends came from Nellore to Hyderabad for driving for any car or any taxi or anything. Okay, when I met him here, he was saying ki, after 1 year I met him. Vinky agents now, I said, "Praveen, I am now real estate agent. I am in real estate business." Oh my god. You know what? I am getting 50,000 per month. I am getting deals. I am selling the properties here. I am selling one property for four persons. Getting commission from all. Oh. పేరు నిలబెట్టారా, యూఆర్ డూయింగ్ వెరీ వెల్. ఐ ఫెల్ట్ సో జెలస్ ఆఫ్ హిమ్. నేనేమో ఐబిసిసి 400 రాస్తున్నా, ఐఎమ్ రైటింగ్ 400 ఆఫ్ ఐబిసిసి, దిస్ గై ఈస్ మేకింగ్ మచ్ మోర్ మనీ దాన్ ఈవెన్ ఐ క్వాలిఫైడ్. ఫైన్, ఐ వెంట్ టు ముంబై. ఆఫ్టర్ 3 ఇయర్స్ ఐ కేమ్ బ్యాక్, ఐ కాల్డ్ హిమ్ అగైన్. ఓకే, ఐ ఆస్క్డ్ హిమ్ వేర్ ఆర్ యూ. He asked Praveen, where are you? I said, I am at Vidyanagar. He said, I am coming here. Oh, I thought he is coming with car and all. He has come in auto. He said that I am driving auto now. And what happened is, Mama, I lost all the money. It's gone. I bought a flat for 20 lakhs. The prices are gone to 10 lakhs. I borrowed that money. Now I have defaulted on the loan. I am in the verge of bankruptcy. Now I am going to drive auto. I will give you free of cost. ఏమైపోయిందని లైఫ్, వాట్ హ్యాపెన్ టు లైఫ్. బట్ దీస్ థింగ్స్ ఆర్ కామన్ థింగ్స్ వెర్ యూఆర్ నాట్ ఏబుల్ టు ఎగ్జిట్ ఎట్ ప్రాపర్ టైమ్ ఇన్ ద సెక్టర్. కమింగ్ బ్యాక్ హియర్, రియల్ ఎస్టేట్ సెక్టర్, యూ మైట్ బి నోయింగ్ 2008 పీరియడ్ వెన్ ప్రైసెస్ పీక్డ్ అండ్ కంటిన్యూ టు క్రాష్ లేటర్ ఆన్. ఫస్ట్ ఎకనామిక్ కండిషన్స్. ఇఫ్ ఇండియన్ ఎకానమీ ఇస్ డూయింగ్ వెల్, యాజ్ ఐ సెడ్, దేర్ విల్ బి మోర్ మనీ అవైలబుల్ ఇన్ పబ్లిక్. యాజ్ యూ హావ్ మోర్ మనీ, యూ విల్ బి టెంప్టెడ్ టు బై వన్ ప్రాపర్టీ. Then you are tempted to buy second property. Chennaiyilu, Pettillu antam. Okay. Now don't take another way. Okay. There's small house and a big house. Okay. Now, interest rates. If interest rates are quite low, you will buy properties. If interest rates are quite high, you will keep down. Now, housing prices. If the prices are high, you will think, arre, prices are quite high. We can't afford to spend 70, 80 lakhs. The consumption demand will be automatically slows down. Okay. And no need to say the consumption will come down only because of interest rates tightening by RBI. Tightening means increasing interest rates by RBI. Population growth, population is increasing in India, we need more houses. There is no doubt about it. Okay, that is another reason why real estate may do very well going forward. Income tax benefit. Section 24, up to 1.5 lakhs you will get exemption from your interest, deduction from your interest in house property. Remember? Of each act? Income tax act. There is separate act also, income tax, if I am not wrong. 1961. Or, if the income tax limit is 80C is also available for principal payment as well, right? Okay. If these benefits withdrawn, half of the prices will fall because there is no benefit on spending for interest for you. Okay. You will lose interest on the loan. You will lose interest in buying the property because of interest on loan. Move on. Now, what are the companies, sir? DLF, half of the people knows DLF only after IPL, but the company is there for the past 30 years. Okay, Unitech, an Indiabulls real estate, Ansal Properties and Shobha Developers, Bangalore based. If you see the stock price movements now, you will be seeing surprising print. No need to see how the sector performed, just see the stock price. Can you see the stock price was 30 paisa in 2003-2004? Can you see here? The stock of Unitech, the price of Unitech for the past 10 years. 30 paisa stock has gone up to 540 rupees. Don't try to calculate the return. Okay, you will go crazy, you will go mad. Sir, how can we spot, sir? That is what we have to do, something called investment research or investment analysis. It's a fugat when I will get these kind of stocks, sir. Now people know Unitech, but before that no one knows that there will be a real estate boom in the economy. 30 paisa stock has gone up to 2008, 540 rupees. What people do, at 540 they will enter. Alright, price is going up and going up and going up and anything which will go up is supposed to fall. Less than normal, someday it will crash, you are gone. Okay, and price has crashed drastically, unstoppable fall. Okay, free fall. This is something which will be explained saying ki markets go in the staircase and the falls in the lift. Okay, bring it up slowly. Right, opposite part of it. Okay, now moving ahead, the price is now available at 12 rupees. Can you buy now at 12 rupees? Sir? Yes, sir. No, no, there is no answer. Maybe. Yes. No. Yes or no, I will tell you after 1 year, not now. Okay, now. Going to next level. So this is the price of the company. It's clearly given economic conditions drive the stock price of real estate. What are the investment mantras? Very interesting mantras. One needs to follow these mantras to make money in the markets. Okay. quite simple. Warren Buffett, who is investment analyst, investment legend of USA, you can see one girl crying there. Do you know the reason why she is crying? Any guess? Breakup. Ayayo, where are you? Somebody says no one is crying because of breakup, because they are looking for a better opportunity. Hey, what about the guru? No problem, no need to worry. Huh? Where are you? You are in 1970s. Huh? 2014 man. In fact, the girls also manage the portfolio. Okay. Of course, boys also manage the portfolio. Huh? Okay, this is a thing which I am surprised to see with today's youth. Boys or girls, both are managed, or both income level. Move on. Fine, this is not a breakup. You can see the stock price falling. Okay, you can see she has bought some stock from stock price per quindi. That's why she is crying. Investment number one. Mantra number one. Never lose money in the stock market, given by Warren Buffett. He has given rule number two also, that is, never forget rule number one. Quite simple. Sir, how sir? Unfortunate part is that after you lose money only, you realize that you lost money in the market, sir. Okay, by that time damage will be already happened. Now, mantra two. Go on. People tend to get tempted by the stock market price. Mama, prices are going up, bro. I can't control. One day came and asked, sir, I want to use credit card by buying shares. Is it possible? How much credit card limit? How much is the stipend? Sir, stipend is 5,000 rupees. My limit is 15,000 rupees. Why do you want to borrow interest? Sir, prices are going up, sir. I can't control. Akade control yes, go on. That is what is called emotional control. Never borrow money for investment in the market. Because when you borrow for money for buying, no. Someday what will happen? Prices may fall. Because of some factors, the company may be doing very well. Take the S Bank, you borrowed the money investment at 200 rupees. Price has gone up to 500 rupees, had fallen to 300. That guy from whom you borrowed, he will come and ask, where is my money, where is my money? If you tell him, wait for some 1 or 2 years, he will say, I want my money immediately. So, never borrow money in the market, sir. Okay. Sir, can I do margin trading? That is also borrowing only. Okay. If you borrow money in the stock market, sir, be careful. Don't let the borrower, lender know that you are investing in markets, sir. Don't tell everyone that I am investing in markets, sir. Okay. Now, but the best thing is, sir, never borrow money for investment in stock markets. Mantra 2. You can see that two enemies in the market, sir. Someone is saying 500 crores, sir. Someone is saying 100%. You are all in the 95% category. You will be losing money in the market, sir. Don't be greedy in the market. Like one guy came and told me, now, sir, I will invest 10,000 rupees. In 1 year, can you make it 1 crore? I said, I will tell you after 1 year. You give me 10,000 first. Okay, so the problem is that when the people enter the market, they will enter with the emotion that we have to mint the money in the market, sir. That is not possible so easily. Okay, minting money is not so easy job. That is where people get badly screwed up because of the emotions carried away. Greed means you want to make money more night. Not possible. You have to buy good stock, hold for 3-4 years. After 3-4 years, you will realize whether you made money, profit or not in the market. Okay. Now, for example, banking is going to do very well. Buy the banking stock, hold for 3-4 years. Don't see every day. Parvinda, Lechinda, Parvinda, Lechinda. Don't do that. Okay. Don't see every second. See over the year-to-year basis whether the stock price reflects the fundamentals of the company. For example, Russia attacked Ukraine. Prices will fall. But tomorrow when they come for agreement, prices will rise again. The sentiment is a short term. In the short term, market price determined by money supply. In the short term, money moves the market, forget the fundamentals. Fundamentals are irrelevant. For example, you are in a deep crisis. You want to go for some serious, you are going to USA for urgent job, urgent employment, urgent education. You will sell your house, even though the house is very much valued, even the house is having a very much rental income, you will try to sell. Or you want to go for a serious heart surgery for your grandparents, you will sell the house any cost. It doesn't mean that the property is not having a proper value. The value is because of the emotions of the people, urgency of the people to sell the stock. American investor will sell the stock tomorrow because they are going to fight with Russia. It doesn't mean that the company fundamentals are bad. Once the war is over, stock prices will bounce back. Will bounce back. You need to start investing at that time when there is a bad news, that is the right time to invest. And we stick to the stock for long term. No need to think that every day you want to mint money left and right. Not possible. You can see left hand picker is so much greedy in the market. Okay, he's dreaming about the dollars, dollar dreams. Right hand side, Wolf of Wall Street, best example. Right hand side, you have fear because the price is falling. You can see he's trying. Okay, the reason why he's trying is not breakup, the reason why she's trying is she is worried about the fall in the price every day. Your price is falling, I have invested. Don't worry. Let it go up after some time, after 1 or 2 years. In the long term, stock price is the slave to company fundamentals. In the short term, money moves the market and forgets the fundamentals. Okay, move on. This is a mantra 3. Don't have these emotions. You can see here, people keep buying a stock because it is going up. Right? Stock price gone up from 30 rupees to 50 rupees in 1 month. I will buy the stock. Any other reason? No reason. It is going up now. I will also catch the bull so that I will ride on the bull. Don't do that. You cannot catch the bull when the bull is already running. Here, first case, he was sitting on the bull before the run starts. You have to buy the stock, hold on to stock, and it will start running. Sometimes you will be sitting on the bull and the bull will sit for some time. Don't get down. Stock price may not move the moment you bought. You are not Warren Buffett. So hold the stock, tightly sit on the bull by holding that bull. And once you start running up, you will enjoy the ride. But unfortunate problem is that people tend to buy the stock when it is going up. I mean, bull is already running. They will try to climb on the bull. Is it possible? No. That bull will kill you. That bull will kill you. The bull will end its run and it will concentrate on killing you. Bull will take a U-turn. Okay. This is a problem. Don't try to catch the bull when it is already running up. Okay, so don't try to catch the stock when the stock has already started going up. Leave it. Just leave it. Move on. Who is this guy? He is a guy who has invested and getting relaxed. Once you bought a stock, don't worry even if it falls. Even if it is false, even if you worry, don't react. And tell them that stock price falling, just to close your hands, close your eyes, and forget that you invested that money. Sometime after later, it will automatically happen that you forgot that I invested that stock. Okay, if you bought a fundamentally good company, for example, you thought that Tata Steel is a strong company to invest, where the stock price may go up in the next 6 months' time. Today the price has fallen. Don't worry. We recommend a stock of LIC Housing Finance at 2:30 in the morning and the price has fallen to 2:26. One guy message, sir, 2:26, sir, shall I sell it? Are you here to sell at loss or are you here to sell at profit? One day negative movement doesn't necessarily mean that it will continue for a long time. Company is strong, company is very good. Tomorrow or day after they may get the banking licenses also, if they are operated already. Within 2 weeks then the banking license will be out. If they are converted into a full-fledged bank, today it is NBFC. Now tomorrow it will be full-fledged bank. It will be another S bank after 5 years. No need to worry. Buy and hold. Buy right, sit tight. It is advertisement I could see in Mother Roswell. Okay. So buy right and sit tight and forget about it and enjoy. Once you bought, don't worry if it falls. Even if it's worry, close your eyes and sleep. Don't see it every day. Please relax, go there, be there and stay there. No need to exit at losses. If it falls, what you do now? Buy few more. If it falls further, buy few more. But be careful, ensure that the fundamentals are very good. Sir, Satyam, I bought at 600. Price has fallen to 300. I bought few more. Price fallen to 150. I bought few more. Price went to 6 rupees. I bought few more. What should I do? Simple. Buy a few more. And you will be every company one day. will be my stakeholder. Don't follow this concept of averaging at any price. Okay, you should ensure that the fundamentals are strong before going for further buying the stock. Go on. I don't know why people keep losing money in the markets. I keep listening, "Hey, sir, my dad lost 5 lakhs, my dad lost 10 lakhs, my dad lost 40 lakhs. Then I feel that fortunately my dad is not an investor. Now, the simple way of making money in stock markets is quite simple. Huh? Buy low, sell high. Very simple. Huh? Sir, how sir? When you buy low, it will fall further, that will be new low. When you sell high, it will rise further, again it will be new high. Then how to buy it low, lowest point and sell it highest point? Don't try to catch the lowest point or highest point for buying and selling. Relatively low buy, relatively sell high. For example, around 3 months back, we bought a stock of S Bank at 280. And within a week's time, it has crashed to 220. But we knew that the company is going to do extremely well looking at the company's expectations about the financials. 220 crashed, people asked us, sell. Wait, kangaar padako. Who told you to see the stock price now? Don't see the stock price. Price kept 220. I bought at 280. Few people bought at 220 also. They are a bit late by the time they opened demat account and all. Price came to 220. Then, as per expectations, the stock price may shoot up to 400. After months time, it started going up slowly. From 315, there is a huge demand for the stock, which made the stock price to go to 375. Then I told her, sell. We have made enough profit, exit the seller. One guy called and I told to sell, stock price went up to 390. I did not feel sad. I mean, we made the profit or not. No need to take all the profit with you. A day will come, all the loss will come to you only. Angel will lead up. You don't know where to end up. Okay. So, Mottamantha Nagara was on the roll of the day, Mottamantha Nikki was the day. We sold at 375, price went up to 390. And by that time, students sold at 390. One day called and said, sir, we bought at 240, 230 levels. You recommended at 280. I said, fine, you bought at lowest price, bargain hunting. It is called bargain hunting. Now, sir, that time you said target is 400, no? Why you are telling to sell at 390 only? Are, where are you now? Sir, I am in Guntur, sir. Come to Hyderabad, I will tell you. So, Peter, you bought at 220 less than my price. You sold at 390 higher than my price. Still, you want to worry about 10 rupees profit. You come to Hyderabad, I will tell you. So, don't try to make all the profit. Don't try to buy at the lowest point, sell at the highest point. See, this is the lowest point for the stock of Glenmark. It is moving in the range of 500 to 600. So don't try to catch the lowest point and sell the highest point. See the beauty, this time, second time it has fallen, but it not come to lowest point. It bounced back to 350 rupees above only. Why? No problem. Price is going up. Don't try to sell at 595. You can exit at 570, 580 also. Did you make the profit or not? Yes. Whatever you make, be happy and leave the market. You might be knowing the movie Chiranjeevi acted, Challenger. The beauty, he says that he will put 10 paisa, he will pay 100 rupees, he will leave the place. Then the other asks, why are you leaving? You can play for some more time. He says that a wise person will not be in the gambling for long time. In the short term, you exit the market. Okay, so the stock price is following the trend. You can see the highest, there is supply at 600 and buying at 490. The moment it closes above 600, there will be next leg of rally that will start for the stock. Okay, don't try to catch the bottom and top, only fools try to do that. Okay, relatively low, relatively high. We made the profit or not. Now, you can see she is saying something to her. Now, what is that? Any guess what she is saying to her and which you can see her expression, no? She is very much excited. Okay. What she is saying is, hey, I got to know one stock, that stock price will go up, you buy the stock. don't believe on rumors. There are people to spread rumors only in the market. Okay, so he will tell to her. She will tell to someone. He will tell to someone. And everyone will buy the stock. By that time, the company promoters will sell the stock and run away from the company. Don't believe in rumors. Don't fall for rumors in the market. If you analyze the company is good, then only you will try to buy the stock. Okay, otherwise, don't enter to buy the stock. Simple. Next, mantra 8. Next. Some people say, "Arey, price is falling, shall I buy?" Not necessary. Just because the price is falling, not necessarily that you can buy the stock. Sir, company fundamentals are good, that time you can buy. But just because the price is falling, don't try to buy the stock. I mean to say, don't try to go against the trend. For example, Sensex is at 22,000. Sir, is it time to sell? Wait na. Fundamentals are fine. We are going to see recovery in the Indian economy. Why should you worry about the fall? buy and hold for some time. Okay. You just need to buy the stock and hold for longer time. Okay. Next. So don't try to go against the trend in the stock prices. Next. Now, can you see a room here? Don't expect that entire profit in the market should come to me. This is what I need to say. See, you are in the market, this is called stock market room. There is a huge money, wherever you see you spend currency. If I give you a chance, you go and take money, what you will do? You will take 3-4 gunny bags, you will take 3-4 gunny bags, and you will exit from within 1 hour, 1.5 hours. Do chest now. Mottam liars come in again. Don't have that ambition. Market will be there. Stocks will be there. Buy the stock and make some profit and exit. Sir, mottam maakara ankoddu, one day will come, mottam neeke vastundi, loss. Okay, don't expect that entire profit will come to me, a day will come. Entire loss will love you. You don't know where to escape also. It will hug you, it will marry you. You have no option to escape. Okay. Now, so in this kind of situation also, that's what I mean to say. Even by looking at this tons and tons of money, don't be greedy. Don't be greedy. For so much of money you will take. No. Take whatever you want and exit. Next. Time bomb danger, 7:55, the time bomb will blast at 8 o'clock. You will see a lot of movies, no? Hero will go and he will cut somewhere, it will automatically stop. We don't know what where he cuts. Okay. Sometimes you will find hero will be running and it will be 7:59. Hero will be keep on running. And that will be shown in the 3 minutes in the movie. He will be keep running only. Alright, it is not blasting or what? God knows, huh? You diffuse any, you cut anywhere, automatically diffuse ho jayega. Okay. So here, people have something called greedy in the market, which makes them to enter into the market called derivatives market. Derivatives also called financial weapons of mass destruction. You are hating your uncle, bring him to derivatives market. Within 1 month, we will ensure that he will give his daughter to you only, no option. Aina nuve daruna babu, get married to my daughter. That means you will be able to bring him to that level. That is the beauty of derivatives, okay? So, be extremely careful in playing the markets. Derivatives is like a double-edged sword. If you don't know how to play, you yourself will get killed. Okay? That is a danger zone where it is not your level to enter a derivatives market. You get experience of 3-4 years in understanding the fundamentals, the financials, economic cycles in the market. Once you find, yes, I am able to follow, that time also don't enter derivatives. Derivatives are not for the common people. That is why in derivatives you cannot buy 1 share or 2 share. They have given it lots. Okay. Each lot is happens to approximately 4.5 lakhs. Sorry, 5 lakh rupees. Okay. So don't enter derivatives just to make money in the markets. Okay, don't be too much greedy to make money in derivatives. Next. For any information, any stock recommendations, you can call me. But be careful. You have to follow my fundas for investment. Even if it falls, I keep saying buy. You need to have something called patience. Stock price peripheries range early. I will say buy only. Buy further. Buy, keep buying further. There is no point in worrying. Okay. So this is the fundas we follow. So unless you have patience, don't enter the market. You can add me in Facebook also, SFM Praveen. And website is www.sfmcoaching.com. That's my mobile number. Don't call me. You can message me. I will reply you within no time. Okay. I am very much thankful to all of you for making the big success. This is my first seminar. We are in a classroom for addressing some people. I hope this kind of seminars will be conducted going forward, where we'll discuss about the why dollar. This is absolutely basics we discussed. Okay, thinking as if you are a layman. Okay, but going forward we'll have seminars on derivative explanation. We'll have seminars on U.S. economy. We'll have seminars on dollars. We'll have seminars on the global economy going forward, or status of Indian economy. So I made a lot of effort to come back to the basic level after more than 6 years at the time when I learned about stock market. Okay. Any other questions, any other queries you have, they'll open the session for Q&A. Any questions you are allowed to ask me? Bye-bye.
Please be seated.
Sorry?
Please be seated, sir.
Acha, please be seated.
You need to fill up the feedback form and submit it to the attenders. And the next thing is, I request sir to present a memento to provincial. Clap, students.
The reason we have an example.